Hello everyone. This is Dr. Adel Bondok, Professor of Anatomy and Neuroscience, Mansoura University, Egypt. Today I am going to talk about the superior mesenteric artery and the inferior mesenteric artery. But just reminding you of the three divisions of the gut. The gut is divided into foregut, midgut, and hindgut. The foregut is supplied by the celiac trunk. The midgut is supplied by the superior mesenteric artery. And the hindgut is supplied by the inferior mesenteric artery. So foregut celiac trunk, midgut, superior mesenteric artery, hindgut, inferior mesenteric artery. Okay, so we have foregut, midgut, and hindgut. You should know the landmark between each gut, okay? The landmark between the foregut and the midgut is the biliary orifice. This biliary orifice is located in the middle of the second part of the duodenum. And the landmark between the midgut and the hindgut is the junction between the right 2/3 and the left 1/3 of the transverse colon. The foregut is supplied by the celiac artery. And the celiac artery takes origin from the front of the abdominal aorta, opposite the upper border of L1 or opposite T12. The midgut is supplied by the superior mesenteric artery, which takes origin from the front of the abdominal aorta, at the level of the lower border of L1 in the transpyloric plane. The hindgut is supplied by the inferior mesenteric artery, which takes origin also from the front of the abdominal aorta opposite the third lumbar vertebra in the subcostal plane. Therefore, the duodenum is supplied by the celiac and the superior mesenteric artery. The transverse colon is supplied by the superior mesenteric artery and inferior mesenteric artery. Okay, let us talk about the superior mesenteric artery. What should you know about this artery? Of course, you should know the origin. Okay, the origin from the front of the abdominal aorta. You should know the course or the landmarks in the course. You should know the termination, where and how it terminates, okay? And then the branches. And finally, there is a syndrome associated with the superior mesenteric artery. It's called superior mesenteric artery syndrome. Okay, so let us start by the origin of the superior mesenteric artery. Regarding the origin of the superior mesenteric artery, you should remember 5 points. The first point, from the front of the abdominal aorta, okay, behind the neck of the pancreas, at the level of the lower border of L1, in the transpyloric plane. And the last point is at the angle between the superior mesenteric artery and the abdominal aorta is filled with fat. Okay, so what are the 5 landmarks in the origin of the superior mesenteric artery? First, front of the abdominal aorta. Second, behind the neck of the pancreas. Third, at the level of the lower border of L1. The fourth, in the transpyloric plane. And finally, the angle between the superior mesenteric artery and the abdominal aorta is filled with fat. Okay, this is the third part of the duodenum. So this is the origin of the superior mesenteric artery. Okay, now the course or the landmarks. Okay, what are the landmarks in the course of the superior mesenteric artery? First landmark here, at its origin. So at its origin, it lies behind the neck of the pancreas. This is the neck of the pancreas. So first landmark in the course, okay, behind the neck of the pancreas. Second landmark here, it passes in front of the uncinate process of the pancreas. This is the uncinate process. Third landmark here, it passes in front of the third part of the duodenum. And the fourth landmark, it passes in the root of the mesentery, on the left side of the superior mesenteric vein. So the superior mesenteric vein is on its right side. So what are the landmarks of the course of the superior mesenteric artery? First landmark here, behind the neck of the pancreas. Then in front of the uncinate process. In front of the third part of the duodenum, in the root of the mesentery. Again, landmarks, first landmark, behind the neck of the pancreas, in front of uncinate process of the pancreas, in front of the third part of the duodenum, then enters the root of the mesentery. How about the termination? It terminates here. Termination, it terminates by anastomosis with the ileal branch of the ileocolic artery. So this is the termination of the superior mesenteric artery. Superior mesenteric artery terminates by anastomosis with the ileal branch of the ileocolic artery. So these are the landmarks of the superior mesenteric artery. Behind the neck of the pancreas, in front of uncinate process, in front of the third part of the duodenum, in the root of the mesentery. Okay, what are the branches? Okay, first, this is the first branch. This one. Inferior pancreaticoduodenal artery. So this is the inferior pancreaticoduodenal artery. Second branch is this one. Middle colic artery. And then right colic artery. This one. And the ileocolic artery. And then these branches, which supply the jejunum and the ileum, jejunal and ileal branches. Jejunal branches and ileal branches. Inferior pancreaticoduodenal supplies the lower part of the head and the uncinate process, and supplies the lower half of the duodenum, lower part of the second part, third part, and the fourth part. So this is the inferior pancreaticoduodenal. Second branch, middle colic artery. This middle colic artery enters the transverse mesocolon. This is the transverse mesocolon. Divides into left branch and right branch. The left branch, anastomosis with the left colic artery. The right branch, anastomosis with the right colic artery. This middle colic artery supplies the right 2/3 of the transverse colon. This is the right colic artery. Right colic artery divides into ascending branch and descending branch. The two branches supply the ascending colon. Then the ileocolic artery. This ileocolic artery divides into colic branch and ileal branch. This colic branch supplies the ascending colon. The ileal branch supplies three structures. This is the ileal branch. Supplies the cecum by anterior and posterior cecal arteries. Supplies the vermiform appendix by appendicular artery and the terminal part of the ileum. And then jejunal and ileal branches supplies the jejunum and ileum. These branches anastomose with each other and form a series of arterial arcades. The arterial arcades are simple in the jejunal part and are complicated in the ileal part. Again, branches of the superior mesenteric artery. This is the first branch, inferior pancreaticoduodenal artery. It supplies the lower part of the head and the uncinate process of the pancreas. It also supplies the lower part of the lower half of the duodenum. lower half of the second part, third part, and the fourth part of the duodenum. Okay, you can say it supplies the duodenum below the biliary orifice. Okay, second branch, this is the middle colic artery. The middle colic artery supplies the right two thirds of the transverse column. It divides into left branch and right branch. Left branch, anastomosis with the left colic artery. Right branch, anastomosis with the right colic artery. Then the right colic artery. Right colic artery divides into ascending branch and the descending branch. The ascending branch, anastomosis with the right branch of the middle colic. The descending branch, anastomosis with the ileocolic artery. The right colic artery supplies the ascending colon. Then the ileocolic artery, this is the ileocolic artery. This ileocolic artery divides into two branches. This is the colic branch, okay? Colic branch, and this is the ileal branch. Colic branch supplies the ascending colon. Ileal branch supplies three structures. The cecum, by anterior and posterior cecal arteries, the appendix by the appendicular artery, and the terminal part of the ileum. So the ileal branch of the ileocolic artery supplies the cecum by anterior and posterior cecal arteries, the terminal part of the the appendix, this is the appendicular artery, and the terminal part of the ileum, and then jejunal and the ileal branches. Jejunal and ileal branches, they anastomose with each other, they form a series of arterial arcades. The arterial arcades are simple in the jejunal part, are complicated or complex in the ileal part. What is the superior mesenteric artery syndrome? Again, this is the superior mesenteric artery, this is the abdominal aorta, and this is the third part of the duodenum. The angle between the superior mesenteric artery and the abdominal aorta is filled with fat. This fat. So what is superior mesenteric artery syndrome? Simply, the superior mesenteric artery syndrome is compression of the third part of the duodenum by the superior mesenteric artery. Okay? Compression of the third part of the duodenum, here is the third part is compressed by the superior mesenteric artery. What is the cause? Very simple. It is due to loss of the fat in the angle between superior mesenteric artery and abdominal aorta. Again, what is superior mesenteric artery syndrome? It is compression of the third part of the duodenum by the superior mesenteric artery. Why? It is due to loss of fat between the superior mesenteric artery and the abdominal aorta. Now the inferior mesenteric artery. This is the inferior mesenteric artery. Again, what should you know about it? You should know the origin. Okay, this is the origin. You should know the termination. It terminates here. You should know the course, the landmarks in the course. Termination, here. Here is the termination. Okay, and then the branches. What are the branches? So course, origin, course, termination, and the branches. Start by the origin. This is the origin of the inferior mesenteric artery. Okay, origin of the superior mesenteric artery. So you should remember five landmarks in the origin. What is the first landmark? What is the first point here? From the front of the abdominal aorta. Okay? Behind the third part of the duodenum. This is the third part of the duodenum. At the level of the third lumbar vertebra in the subcostal plane. So what are the landmarks of the origin of the inferior mesenteric artery? Front of the abdominal aorta, it arises from the front of the abdominal aorta behind the third part of the duodenum at the level of L3 in the subcostal plane. Therefore, look at this photo. The third part of the duodenum separates the superior mesenteric artery in front from the inferior mesenteric artery behind. Okay, so this is the origin. How about the landmarks of the course? First landmark. The origin lies behind the third part of the duodenum. And the third part of the duodenum separates the superior mesenteric artery from the inferior mesenteric artery. So what is the first landmark in the course of the inferior mesenteric artery? Number one, the third part of the duodenum, this is the third part, separates the superior mesenteric artery from the inferior mesenteric artery. Second landmark, look at this vein. This vein terminates in the splenic vein. So it is the inferior mesenteric vein. So the inferior mesenteric artery lies medial to the inferior mesenteric vein. Another landmark. Look at this tube. This one. This is the ureter, the left ureter. The inferior mesenteric artery lies medial to the left ureter. The last landmark here. It crosses the middle of the left common iliac artery. This is the left common iliac artery. This is the right common iliac artery. So what are the four landmarks in the course? The first one, third part of the duodenum separates the superior mesenteric artery from the inferior mesenteric artery. Okay. Second one, it lies medial to the inferior mesenteric vein. It lies medial to the ureter. It crosses the front of the middle common iliac artery. So remember, 4 points in the origin and 4 landmarks in the course. 4 points in the origin. Front of the abdominal aorta, behind the third part of the duodenum, opposite the third lumbar vertebra in the subcostal plane. 4 landmarks. The third part of the duodenum separates the superior mesenteric artery from the inferior mesenteric artery. It lies medial to the inferior mesenteric vein. It lies medial to the left ureter. It crosses the front of the middle of the left common iliac artery to continue as the superior rectal artery. So what is the termination? The termination, it continues as the superior rectal artery in front of the middle of the left common iliac artery. So termination continues as superior rectal artery in front of the middle of the left common iliac artery. What are the branches? It gives us 3 branches. This is the first branch, left colic artery. These are the second branches, sigmoid arteries. And the third one is the continuation of the inferior mesenteric artery, which is the superior rectal artery. The left colic artery divides into ascending branch and descending branch, ascending and descending. They supply the left third of the transverse colon and the descending colon. Sigmoid arteries anastomose with each other supplies the sigmoid colon, and then the superior rectal artery, it supplies the rectum and the upper part of the anal canal. Okay, so summarize the branches of the superior mesenteric artery and inferior mesenteric artery, actually they supply the colon. So what is the arterial supply of the large intestine? large intestine is supplied by superior mesenteric artery and inferior mesenteric artery. Superior mesenteric artery supplies the midgut. Okay, midgut. Of course, the jejunum, the ileum, the appendix, cecum, ascending colon, and the right 2/3 of the transverse colon. So regarding the large intestine, cecum, appendix, ascending colon, and the right 2/3 of the transverse colon. Regarding the inferior mesenteric artery, it supplies the hind gut, left 1/3 of the transverse colon, descending colon, sigmoid colon, rectum, and the upper part of the anal canal. So what is the arterial supply of the cecum? This is the cecum. The cecum is supplied by anterior cecal and the posterior cecal branches from the ileocolic artery. Okay? So anterior cecal and the posterior cecal arteries from the ileocolic artery from the superior mesenteric artery. How about the ascending colon? Appendix. Okay, appendix. It is supplied by the appendicular artery. This appendicular artery from the ileal branch of the ileocolic artery of the superior mesenteric artery. Then the ascending colon. This is the ascending colon. It is supplied by the ileocolic and the right colic arteries. Of course, from the superior mesenteric artery. Okay. Then the transverse colon. This is the transverse colon. It is divided into right 2/3 and the left 1/3. The right 2/3 from the superior mesenteric artery. The left 1/3 from the inferior mesenteric artery. Because the right 2/3 develop from the mid gut, the left 1/3 from the hind gut. Okay? How about the descending colon? Descending colon. This is the left colic artery. Okay? And these are the sigmoid branches. Okay? So left colic artery and the sigmoid arteries. How about the sigmoid colon? This is the sigmoid colon, sigmoid branches of the inferior mesenteric artery and the sigmoid mesocolon. Okay, how about the rectum? The rectum is supplied by 3 arteries. This is the superior rectal artery, supplying the upper part of the rectum, superior rectal artery from the inferior mesenteric artery. And then middle rectal artery from the internal iliac artery. And the inferior rectal artery from the internal pudendal artery. And the internal pudendal is branched from the internal iliac artery. So these are the branches of the mesenteric arteries supplying the large intestine. Now let us talk about this artery, this arterial anastomosis, okay, along the margin of the large intestine. It's called the marginal artery. So what is the marginal artery? This is the marginal artery. Marginal artery. So the marginal artery is the artery around the margin of the large intestine. And it is formed by anastomosis of the colic arteries. Anastomosis of the colic arteries. And thank you very much. Best wishes and good luck, and see you again, inshallah.